Paxi. My name is Anne McClain, and I'm an American astronaut on board the International Space Station. Today, I'd like to talk to you about the mental challenges of being an astronaut here on the space station. We're on here for long periods of time. The space station is not only for science and technology experiments, it's also an experimental setting to study how people behave and communicate and feel when they live in a small, closed space far away from home. And this is important because in the future, when humans go to the moon and Mars, they'll be even farther away from home and for an even longer amount of time. Paxi, maybe you already know some of these challenges of living in space. You yourself are very far from home, and I can imagine that sometimes you miss your planet and your friends. Here on the space station, I'm very close to my planet Earth and I can see it all the time. But I have to stay on the station for 6 months at a time, and sometimes we stay even longer. My fellow astronauts and I are all trained for these conditions, and we have a big team of scientists and doctors who help us when we are on our mission. And I'm glad that you're here with us. I also have my astronaut friends to keep me company. We eat dinner together and have fun talking about our day. However, it can also be difficult to be confined for such a long period of time. Here on the station, it's very important that we always work together. I also sometimes miss the smells, sounds, and colors back home. Another challenge we have here on the ISS is that we don't have a normal day and night cycle. We have 16 days, actually. The space station goes around the Earth very quickly, so we see all these 16 sunrises and sunsets every 45 minutes. And this means our sleep patterns can be a little bit disturbed. It's important to study the challenges of being away from home for a long period in a confined space in order to be able to successfully plan future travel to other distant places. Maybe we can go as far as you did. When humans will go to Mars, they will be gone for years, and it will be harder to talk to people back home because it will take the signal a really long time to travel between Earth and Mars. Like a really bad phone connection where you say something and then you get an answer like 40 minutes later. Here we can just talk on the phone pretty normally, actually. To be able to go to Mars, we need to practice how to handle these problems and come up with solutions. That is one of the things that we're doing on ISS. Paxi, did you know that we're also preparing to go to Mars by simulating missions on Earth? Let's take a look at some of that footage. In the Mars 500 experiment, six people lived for more than 500 days on a base that looks like a Mars base. Like me, they couldn't go outside without spacesuits, and they were isolated. ESA also supports an awesome research station in the Antarctic called Concordia. Here, the crew is living isolated for 9 months. During the winter months, there's no sunlight and the average temperature is negative 50 degrees Celsius. They can rarely go outside, they cannot go home, and they have a small crew. So Paxi, hopefully you see that space travel is not just about machines and technological challenges. It's as much about how our minds cope with living in a strange place far from home. How we work together and how we keep not only a healthy body, but also a healthy mind. It's really been a pleasure talking to you today, Paxi, and I'll see you next time aboard the International Space Station. Thank you.